Let's take a look at how you can add a Flutter app to Bitrise. After logging in, click on the Add New App button and then choose the web UI. Choose the Bitrise account you want the app to be added to. It can be either your personal account or an organization. Choose a privacy type for your app. If it's public, anyone can see your logs and configs, so be sure to use this with care. We will set this one to private. Select your repository from the source code provider of your choice. You can choose GitHub, Bitbucket, GitLab, or add something else manually. The test app we are going to use is stored on GitHub. When prompted to set up repository access, you can either add your own SSH key, which comes in handy if you need to set up multiple sub-repositories, or just go for the No Auto Add SSH key option. Choose and type the name of your branch. Pick one that includes the config of your project. My branch is called Master. And now the validation of the repository is running. Bitrise will check if it's fully accessible and will also look for your project type. The result is used to create the best configuration for your needs. Let's fast forward a bit. Bitrise detected a Flutter project. Great, we are in business. At this point, you need to decide whether or not you want to run tests found within the project. By default, you will probably want to select yes for this, even if you don't have any. Next, you need to select an IPA export method. I will go with development. Once you've read through the project build configuration offered by the scanner, you can click confirm your settings or edit them if needed. Now you can add an icon to your app. Either choose one we found in your repo or upload one. Last but not least, we need to register a webhook when prompted, so that Bitrise can start a build automatically when code is pushed to your repository or a pull request is created. This also kicks off your first build. Click on the big green button and you will be taken to the build's landing page.